So this video is going to be all about memory, and specifically all about memory in LangChain. As far as user interactions, when it comes to LLMs, LLMs are stateless. So this means that the LLMs don't save any information in the conversation that occurred in the conversation earlier. So it's stateless. Let's take a look at an example. Now, if I'm going to ask my large language model that is based on the LangChain documentation who created LangChain, then I would get a correct response that it was created by Harrison Chase. But if I'm going to follow up and ask, do you know any YouTube videos related to him? Then the answer that I will get is, I'm sorry, I don't know who you're referring to. Could you please provide me with more context or clarify who is him? So the concept that we're discussing right now in the formal terminology is called a co-reference resolution. Basically, it's the task of identifying all expressions, words, or phrases in a text that refer to the same entity or concept. So in other words, it's the process of identifying all the instances where different words or phrases in a text refer to the same thing. And in our example, him referred to Harrison Chase. Now, the LLM was not able to do it because it didn't have a state, so it wasn't able to make a coreference resolution. However, if the LLM in the prompt will get the state and the chat history, then it will be easily able to make the coreference resolution. And this is the underlying base to all the solutions that LangChain is currently supporting for memory. We simply find sophisticated ways to pass into the prompt some data, some information that will help the LLM to make some co-reference resolution, like in the example we see right now. The prompt that we're giving it is, given the past conversation, answer my question. Now, in the past conversation, we're simply going to answer an interaction between us and the bot, something about, I like drinking cold brew coffee, where can I get it? And the last question is, where else can I find that? And by that, I am co-referencing the cold brew coffee. And also, the LLM will know that I don't want to drink at Starbucks nor at Coffee Bean. And the LLM can easily process that and can make some co-reference resolution. Now, you may notice that if we have a 1 hour conversation, then we are in a problem because we have too much data to put into the prompt. We know that there is a token limit for around 4,096 tokens. So if we have an hour long conversation, then it will definitely exceed this token. Okay, so now let's see how LangChain resolves it, and let's take a look at all of the LangChain offerings regarding memory. Now, this video is a theoretical video, so I'm not planning to show you any live examples of how to use them. They're pretty straightforward, and we're going to see examples of them in the rest of this course. So don't worry about seeing implementations of those classes. Right now, what I want to demonstrate to you is the strategies that are used in order to resolve this token issue when it comes to memory. Okay, let's start by talking about the conversation buffer memory. So in this class, we simply save a buffer of all the history of our chat, and we pass this buffer into the context of the prompt every time. Okay, so it's very similar to the example we saw before and super, super easy to use because all we do is simply plug into our chains this buffer memory object, and that's pretty much it. So though it's easy to use, it has a couple of limitations because if we're going to have a long conversation, then the buffer is going to get bigger and bigger and bigger, and eventually it will pass the token limit. So it's useful when we have a small interaction or we want to save only a couple of messages and that the user is not going to continue and rely on an ancient history here. Okay, now let's review just a little bit in depth the documentation of the conversation buffer memory. So we can see that here we are initializing the conversation buffer memory, and we're using a function which is called save context. Now here we supply two arguments. One is going to be the user input and the other is going to be the AI response. So in this example, the user is going to put hi and the AI is going to return what's up. So when we use this function, we actually save it in the buffer. Now we have also a function to load it from the buffer, which is called load memory variables. And when we use it, we can see that the output we get is a dictionary where the key of history is a one-liner that is going to combine both of the message from the human, which was hi, and then backslash n, then what the AI returned, which is what's up. Okay, so this is basically the functions that are in the conversation buffer memory class. Now, LangChain is going to be calling it and using it under the hood for us, so we won't need to do it manually. Now, if you want it in another format, we can use the return messages argument to be true. And in this case, then the response when we get back, when we load it from the memory, then will be a list of an object which is called a human message and an object which is called an AI message. Okay, so this is basically a wrapper and different representations of the same data. Now, I want to mention again that we're not going to explicitly call save context and load memory variables in most of our usage. So this will be done by LangChain, the framework, when you use it inside the chain that is going to do it. Okay, so now let's see how we use it in the chain. And it's very, very simple. So let's say we are using the conversation chain to have a chat conversation. All we need to do in order to use the buffer memory is to pass to the conversation chain the argument of memory to be equal to the conversation buffer memory object that we created. Now, because we put the verbose equals true, so we'll have a sneak peek of what's happening underneath the hood with the memory buffer. Okay, so we tell the AI, hey there. Okay, so we get a response back. Hi there, it's nice to meet you. How can I help you? But before that, we can see that the AI, the LLM, printed something about the current conversation. Now, we can see that the current conversation now is empty. And of course, it's empty because we haven't really talked yet. Okay, so let's say that we continue from now. And let's say we tell the LLM now, I'm doing well, just having a conversation with the AI. Now let's take a look at the verbose logs that the LLM is outputting us, and let's take a look at the value of the current conversation. Now we can see that the entire conversation that happened up until now is being logged and being saved by our LLM. So it's not really by the LLM being saved, because we save it to a buffer and the buffer is connected to the LLM. So the LLM has this information. So it simply formats it nice and it's able to use this information to answer our questions. Okay, so you can see now the buffer got bigger. It was before an empty buffer and now has the conversation of hi there and the response we got, hi there, it's nice to meet you, how can I help you today, and so on and so on. So every time we continue another prompt and another prompt, we're going to make this buffer bigger and bigger and bigger. And overall, LangChain is saving us work by taking this buffer and plugging it into our prompt before we send it to the LLM. So we have an augmented prompt with the buffer. Okay, let's discuss now conversation buffer window memory. Now, this class keeps a list of the interactions of the conversations over time. However, it now uses the last K interactions where we choose the K. So this can be super helpful when we are keeping a sliding window of the most recent interactions, so the buffer doesn't get too large. So basically right here, we limit the buffer. And limiting the buffer is a heuristic that when we will make the call to the LLM and pass this history in the context, then we won't surpass the token limit of the model. And the usage of it is super simple, just like the conversation buffer memory. But this time we provide it with a K argument, which is an integer. So the K represents the last K interactions we want to keep in our memory. So right in the example, the K equals to 2. So this means we're going to keep only 2 messages in the history every time, the latest 2 messages. So now I want to talk about the conversation token buffer memory. Now it's very, very similar to the conversation buffer window memory. Now in the window memory, we only allowed to save only the last K messages. Okay, but in the token buffer memory, we are now limiting not by the number of messages, but the number of tokens that we have stored in the buffer. The default value for this is 2000. So this means that we won't allow the buffer to be over 2000 tokens. Now, every time we will append something to the memory, to the buffer, then we will check the token limit. The default is 2000 tokens. So if we exceed the token limit, then we will need to flush out some messages. So we won't actually need to do anything. LangChain is going to do everything. So you know what? Don't believe me. Let's take a look at the source code of the conversation token buffer memory. Okay, so we can see that when we initialize a conversation token buffer memory, then we have the max token limit that the default is 2000. Now, every time we have an interaction with the LLM, then LangChain is going to use the save context method in order to save and add to the buffer. Now, this save context is a method that is implemented for all of the types of buffer classes that we have. However, This implementation in the token buffer is a bit different. So in this implementation, you can see that we are first checking that if the size of our buffer is exceeding the max token limit. And if it does exist, we simply go and pop out the messages from the oldest until we are not passing that token limit and we are able to continue. So what we saw so far is the buffer memory, which has no limit, the window buffer memory, which restricts the number of messages we want to save, and the token buffer memory, which restricts the number of tokens that we save into the buffer. Okay, so those are the heuristics in order to not to get to surpass the token limit of the LLM. And they are pretty much guardrails. So now it's time to introduce something which is very, very cool in my opinion, which is the conversation summary memory. So it is pretty self-explanatory from the name, but what this memory does for every interaction with the LLM, it summarizes everything. So every point in time, we're going to have the summary of the conversation that we had. And this sort of looks like a story, and we'll soon see an example of this, but it's very, very cool because what LangChain is doing underneath the hood is taking the new conversation, for example, the human prompt and the AI response, making a new call to the LLM with the old summary that we have so far and telling him, hey, this is a summary we have so far. Now we have this new information. Please refine this summary. So this is very, very cool and very, very smart because LLMs are very good at summary. And because of that, we will eventually save tokens. So this is super, super cool in my opinion. It's very elegant, it's very smart, and it really shows you the strength of LangChain, of how many things are underneath the hood that it's doing for you and make it easy to write applications that are LLM powered without you having to deal with everything. So just to give you a taste, I want to show you what does the conversation summary looks like when we are augmenting the prompt, not we, LangChain is augmenting the prompt that we're going to send to the LLM. So you can see that the current conversation is the following. The human greeted the AI and asked how it was doing. The AI replied with it's doing great and currently helping a customer with a technical issue with their computer, was not connecting to the internet. The AI was troubleshooting the issue and had already tried resetting the router, checking the network settings, but the issue still persisted and they are looking into the possible solutions. So this is the summary of all the things that it happens. Now, if we would have simply used another kind of memory like the buffer memory or the token limitation memory, then we would have much more tokens over here. Here we have a very concise and well-refined summary of the conversation. And this is really leveraging the power of LLMs because those models are very good in summarizing things in a very articulate way. Okay, so I like to get my hands dirty. So let's take a look at the source code of this type of summary memory. So I'm going to go to the memory directory and right over here, we have a file which is called summary.py. So here we have the class which is called conversation summary memory. Now in this class, we have a cool function which is called save context. Now you know that this function is being called every time we have a new instance of our conversation. Now this function, what it does, it takes the new input and the chat history and is going to summarize the new input with the current chat history together, which is already a summarization. So this is done by the predict new summary function. Now let's go and check that. Now this function, you can see that it simply gets the old buffer, which is the old summary, and then it uses another chain to simply summarize the old summary with the new input. So you can see this call in line 34. But what's interesting here is to examine the prompt which is being sent to the LLM, to the prompt that will summarize the context of the conversation. Okay, so we're going to go and examine it. Now, this is a fine example of prompt engineering. Sorry about that message, guys. It's my wife. Anyways, we can see right in the prompt, it says, you are an AI assistant reading the transcript of a conversation between an AI and a human. Extract all of the proper nouns from the last line of the conversation. Then the creators of LangChain simply provided with an example one and an example two, which is a classic few-shot prompting technique. Now, you're welcome to learn about few-shot prompting in the theoretical section in this video. And in the last part, you can see we're simply plugging in the history that already exists, the last user input, and in line 84, we have the output indicator, which is called output. So, very, very cool. I mean, this is simply beautiful to see how everything comes together. Prompt engineering, saving boilerplate code to come with an elegant solution of implementing the conversation summary memory. Okay, now it's time to talk about conversation summary buffer memory. Now, this one combines two ideas. So first of all, it keeps a buffer of the recent interactions in the buffer. So the interactions are saved as is. But if we get to the buffer limit, then rather than simply flushing the old interactions, what it does, it compiles the old interactions into a summary and it then uses both. So it's also saving original interaction and also the summary of those interactions. So we can easily see this being implemented in the documentation. Now, the example in the documentation, you can see that in the history of the conversation, the last part of it is regular messages from the AI, from the human. But the first part is the summary. So this is exactly what we talked about. So it's very, very cool and very, very interesting to see. So the next type of memory is called an entity memory. Now, an entity memory is something that remembers things about specific entities. So basically what LangChain is doing underneath the hood is to extract information on the entities. Of course, they're going to do it using LLM calls. And then it will build up some kind of knowledge base about these entities over time. So also using the LLM. So eventually we have a dictionary about our entities and the information that we have so far about them. So I think the best way to demonstrate it is by an example, which will make everything clearer. So in this example, we can see that we're printing the conversation memory and we have an object which is called entity store and dot store. So what is this? This is a dictionary and the keys of this dictionary are the entities that are in our conversation, which the LLM extracted, LangChain extracted to be exact. And LangChain underneath the hood is keeping summaries on those entities and what's new with them and summary about them. So every time the LLM will need to reference one of those entities, it can simply look up in the dictionary in the key of the entity and retrieve information about it. So it's very, very smart and elegant. But to be honest, I haven't implemented this kind of memory in my projects. Okay, so the last memory I would like to talk about is the vector store backed memory. Now, this of course is going to be used a vector store, a vector database like Pinecone, like Weaviate, and we can use any vector database we want. Now, what it's going to do, every interaction that we make, it's going to embed and it's going to turn it into a vector. It's then going to take this vector, it's going to store it in the vector database into the vector store. Okay, so now the vector store is saving the embeddings of every interaction that the user made to the AI. Also, the answers of the AI. So we have everything represented as vectors stored in the vector database. Now, every time the user is going to make a new query to the LLM, then of course we're going to embed this query into a vector and we want to find the k closest vectors to the query of the user. Now, those vectors represent the history of our chat. And we're going to take back those vectors that are the closest to our query and we're going to use them as the context to the LLM. So we're going to tell to the LLM, hey, use these vectors as the history that happened so far. But notice here, because we're using a vector database, we don't really have a guarantee that the vectors we will get will be in the right order. So we may get vectors that represent different parts of the conversation, but are semantically related to the query that the user asked. Now, if this gives you a flashback to the retrieval QA chains that we discussed earlier in this course, then you are correct, because what's happening underneath the hood is exactly the same here. But what's good about this kind of memory, because we're using a vector database, which is external to our machine, which is running now all the LLMs and all the chains, then the amount of data that we can store there of the history is massive. We can store hours of conversation with no issue at all. Eventually, for each query, we will take only the relevant parts of the conversation history that we need. But the solution isn't perfect and it has some drawbacks and it has some trade-offs that we need to consider. And what are the trade-offs? The latency. We first need to embed, and embedding means to create an API call to our embeddings model. Okay, then we need to take this embedding and then we need to make another API call to the vector database to store it in the vector DB. Okay, and now we need to perform some similarity search and to find some semantically related vectors. Okay, that will also take some time. And then we need to get back those vectors from the vector DB. So everything here is increasing the latency. And I don't want to talk about money, because to make all those API calls, all those embeddings, those will cost us money. So when we implement memory, we need to consider all of these trade-offs. Hey guys, Eden here, and I hope you enjoyed this session. I know this session was long. We discussed a lot about the memory types in LangChain, and I wanted even to dive into the source code and to show you that there is nothing genius over here. There is just a lot of stuff that LangChain is doing underneath the hood for us. The concepts are pretty simple, but are beautifully implemented by the framework. So that's why LangChain is so powerful, because if we needed to do it as developers, then it would have taken us so much time to implement memory and to handle all of this, to handle token limitation. And LangChain is really doing all the heavy lifting for us. And that's why I like this framework so much.